This tutorial goes into greater detail on the subject of QList and deals with the QList timing and options of queues in a QList. Thank you for your interest in the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, and welcome to this tutorial. To learn more about the various parts of the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, keyboard, and screen, you are advised to watch Tutorial 1 and 2, Hardware and Software. This tutorial is based on software version 1.3. If your chimp uses a different software version, the functions or user interface may be different. Please note that we refer to the chimp hardware keys as keys and the GUI software keys as buttons in this tutorial. QList timings. Let's start by pressing playback button 10 on the touchscreen. The right of the touchscreen automatically changes to QList view. Now we can see QList 6. To show the timings of a QList, we have set up QList 6 with 4 queues and called it QList timings. By using the bar at the bottom of the QList split widget to scroll to the right, we can see that there are quite a few settings available for each queue. Let's deal with the most important ones first, the basic time settings. In fade. The first settings is the fade time. In our example, it is set to 1 second. The reason this is set to 1 second is because this is how it is set in the timing menu. To change this, we press Setup Menu, followed by Timings. In the pop-up window, the time of the infade is set to 1 second. 1 second is the default value when creating the infade time for queues. We leave this value as it is and go back to Playback. Press the Playback button again. If we wish to change the infade time temporarily, when programming a queue, we press the time key on the chimp keyboard. In our example, we'll press the infade time from 1 second to 5 seconds. Press the value of the infade time on the touchscreen, in our case, 1 second. Then press the set key on the keyboard. Type the value 5 in the pop-up window and then press Enter. All queues that we are now about to program will have a 5-second infade time. This set value remains valid until we press the Clear key, at which point the value we temporarily set will revert to the Timing menu default settings. As soon as we create a new queue, we will see that the infade time is set to the default value of 1 second. To delete the recorded queues, we press the DEL key, followed by the Q key, and 5 through 8. Q5 to Q8 now have been deleted. Trigger. Now, we'll deal with the trigger settings. The default setting for the trigger is manual. You select a whole row beneath a particular attribute, such as this case with trigger, by dragging your finger over all the values. Tip: if the list is very long, the chimp lets you select all values at once by pressing the name of the attribute at the top of the list. Tap Trigger at the top of the QList view window to select the whole row. Then press Set. In the pop-up menu, we can see several ways of activating the queues in the queue list. If we choose Wait, then the queue will wait or set number of seconds before proceeding to the next one. In our example, when we activate the queue list by sliding fader 10 upwards, we'll see that the queues all wait 1 second before proceeding to the following queues. The waiting time is set to 1 second by default. We can change this trigger time by selecting Trig Time and then pressing the Set button. In the pop-up menu, select a trigger time of 3 seconds. All the queues will wait 3 seconds before proceeding to the following queue. To show this even more clearly, let's apply a 0 second trigger time to Q1 and Q3. Now, we can see that the queues immediately proceed at 0 seconds, and the queues that are set to 3 seconds wait 3 seconds before they proceed. In our next example, let's set the trigger to manual go. Select all the set triggers and press Set. Select Manual Go in the pop-up menu. We want to apply a 3-second in-fade time to Q2 in the list. To do this, press the in-fade on Q2, followed by the Set key. Now we enter 3. We want to apply a Follow as trigger to Q3 in the list. We can do this by tapping the trigger corresponding with Q3 on the touchscreen, followed by the Set key. At this point, select the Follow. All queues in this list, apart from Q3, are now triggered manually. Q3 will wait until Q2 has completed its in-fade time before following automatically. In our example, we press Playback button 10 to trigger the queue list to go from Q2 to Q3. We will see that Q2 now runs through the in-fade before Q3 is activated. The queue list stops again because Q4 is set to manual and is waiting for a go. We can also enter a negative value in the trigger time. This value is then subtracted from the previous set trigger time on the previous queue. In our example, we can see that Q2 has an in-fade time of 3 seconds because we entered a negative trigger time of -2 seconds on the next queue. This time will be subtracted from the 3 seconds. Consequently, Q3 will only wait 1 second before Q3 runs the follow. In the following example, we will change the negative value to its positive value. Now, the value is added to the previous queue, and Q3 waits for the in-fade time of Q2, and then it waits for the 2-second trigger time before being run. We can also trigger the queues with a time code. We can do this by tapping Trigger. Now, we select the Time Code option on the touch screen. This option is dealt with in another tutorial. Another way to trigger queues is with a Speedmaster. We tap Trigger again and then press the Set key. Now, we select the Speedmaster option in the pop-up window. In our case, this is Speedmaster 1. On our chimp, we previously created a Speedmaster on Master Fader 1. We can now adjust the speed between the queues by sliding the Master Fader 1 up and down. The last trigger option is the sound trigger. Here too, we can select this by tapping on Trigger in the cue list, then pressing the Set key and selecting one of the sound triggers. This function is dealt with in another tutorial. In delay. Another time function is the in delay. This function ensures that the corresponding cue waits for the set time before performing the function. In our example, we'll set the in delay time to 2 seconds. We can do this by tapping the in delay value on the touchscreen and then pressing the set key. We now enter 2 in the pop-up menu and confirm by pressing Enter. When this cue is triggered, we will see that it waits 2 seconds before running the 3-second in fade. If we set the in fade time to 0 seconds, then this cue will only wait 2 seconds because the set in delay time means the operation runs immediately. There is no in fade time because it has been set to 0. Out fade. Another time function is the out fade. In our example, we set the out fade time in Q4 to 3 seconds. When Q4 is activated, we will see that it uses a 1-second in-fade time, whereas the out-fade time is 3 seconds. That's all for the main settings. We can change more settings relating to timing in the cue list. These functions are set to 0 by default, but we can select another value ourselves. In snap. In the next example, we'll deal with the in snap function. We have prepared a cue, which we select by tapping the playback button 9. Cue list 31 snap appears in the cue list view. We drag the selection bar to the right until we see the InSnap function. The chimp features a fade and a snap function. There are some functions that always fade and others that always snap. A movement will always be a fade. We can see this in our example by starting Q1 followed by Q2. These cues contain a position, a color, and a gobo value. We can see that the movement is a fade, whereas the color and gobo values snap instead. The snap time is set to 0% by default and will immediately snap when starting the cue. We can change the snap time values by selecting it and then pressing the set key. In our example, we enter 50% as snap time and confirm by tapping the enter button. When the cue is started, we see that it only snaps halfway through the execution of the cue. This is at 50% of the cue. If we change this value to 100%, it will only snap at the end of the cue. Comment. Next to the InSnap function in the split widget, we can see the comment column, where we put important information on things such as what has been programmed in the queue. In other words, anything you like. After the comment column, there are more time settings that we can alter. it is important to know that the time settings after the comment column are given a higher priority than the ones in the front of the column. For example, the in fade and in delay. A few other settings. In our example, we'll set the in-snap time back to 0 seconds. We enter a position fade value of 4 seconds. When activating the cue, we see that movement now takes 4 seconds instead of 2 seconds that we had set for the in-fade time. The position's delay is set to 0 seconds by default, so now we will change it to 2 seconds. This means that there will be a 2-second wait before the movement is carried out. However, an immediate snap to the color and gobo will take place at once. The color delay is set to 0 seconds by default, and we, in our example, will change this to 3 seconds. If we now start our cue, we will see that it takes 3 seconds before the color changes. The total time for the cue is still 4 seconds. By way of a final example, we shall change the gobo delay time. Let's set this to 5 seconds. Now, if the cue is started, we shall see that 5 seconds elapse before the gobo changes. The movement or position change will be started, followed by the color change, and finally, the gobo change. This allows us to set when and after what delay the attributes of the fixtures are activated on each cue. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Infinity strives to keep its chimp-related tutorials and software information up to date. Keep an eye on our social media channels for the latest information on the chimp.